Today we're going to try to read the ROM from a 8204668 motherboard. This is from an iMac 21.5 inch mid-2014, and the ROM is located right there. We will be using the Medusa-3 for this, which says it's going to use the Pomona clip, which is exactly what we're going to do. So normally you'd have to be very careful about which way around you clip onto the ROM chip, but this being a Medusa-3, we do not care. So let's see if we can manage to clip onto the beast. With the bleeping, the Medusa indicates that it's smelling which way around it's clipped on. And it's seeing the ROM chip already. Now it's showing all sorts of data from that it's reading from the ROM. And from the data you can see that it is actually reading the ROM. The ROM is right here by the diagnostic LEDs, and you can even see one of the LEDs come on. So we're probably powering half the motherboard in this case. The serial number of the Mac. This is just a scrap board that I bought off AliExpress. So iMac 14.4, which makes sense. The ME region is not clean, but the Medusa can clean it for us if we want. Now you see the clip is clipped on in a particular way. Let's unclip it and turn it around to show you that it really does not matter. So I have the white wire in the front now. I unclip it. Now the Medusa noticed that the ROM is gone. I turn it around and I clip it on again. That is, if I can see it. See, now it actually says reverse, whereas before it said normal. So it knows, it's different from before. And it sees the ROM again. And it's going to show all its data again. To read the ROM, we put it in reading mode, which is like this. Read Mac ROM into Medusa ROM. Smelling the way of the way around the chip is plugged in, and there it goes. It's reading it now. The Medusa checks absolutely everything while reading. So if it loses connection to the ROM chip, it will notice, it will stop, and it will only continue once it sees the ROM chip again. So if I disconnect it now, you see the display stops. And if we clip it back on, it continues where it left off. And the dump it takes from the ROM will always be correct. So there's no need to read it three times and compare the dumps. Of course you can, but you'll notice with the Medusa they will always be the same. Once this is done, you can connect to the auxiliary port of the Medusa. And you could attach that to your normal PC SPI programmer and extract the data from the Medusa into your PC that way. Well, it claims to be ready. So we have read the ROM out of a dead board. So thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed seeing this Medusa 3 in action. Thanks, bye bye.